We are back. We are taking on Miami. We're at home. We're going to see how we can do. Very dominant his last time out. Picked up the win. Only allowed one run. These guys would love to see him back on his game in this one. Ready to go? And now for the Marlins, John Birdie. Next offering is in for a strike. Swing. Oh. I thought that was gonna be gone. I saw it crack up. I went, oh crap. Segura at the plate here, one of the stars in the win yesterday, as he had three hits. On the ground to the left. Whips it to first. Out. Nice efficient start to the afternoon. That's two out. On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. Now at the plate, Luis Arraez. Hot shot to third. Over to Hosmer. Thank goodness. 2-3 go the Marlins. And now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Digging in, Nico Horner. The 1-1 is fouled off. Oof. Another guy who grew up in the Bay Area was a huge fan of those late 80s, early 90s Oakland A's teams. Fastball, and he gets out of the way.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Want to try and tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Line to left. De La Cruz makes the grab. One away. Dansby Swanson stands in. Third in the NL in RBIs this year.
Doing pretty good, though.
Here's a swing.
Yeah, he's doing good. Yep.
Dansby Swanson hits one out. Home run number 10 on the year. And it gives him the lead in the first. It's 1-0. He put a charge into that.
That was a lightning swing right there. No doubt about it.
In half up to hit. Entering this one second in the National League in hitting. Line drive. Can't get their base hit.
I can take a chance.
One down. And now the right fielder, Seiya Suzuki, had the day off yesterday. Let's go, baby. And he deals.
We know that I only play one of the two games in the series. So.
First and second, one out. Here's Cody Bellinger. Fourth on the National League home run leaderboard. The 1-1. On the ground right side.
No.
Six. Three. It's a double play.
Well, we get on the board first, so that kind of helps us.
Solo shot. It's an early 1-0 lead. You're watching Major League Baseball. Back here at the friendly confines. And now here's the veteran DH, Jorge Soler. Next offering is in for a strike. Got him swinging.
Did a pretty rough. He's only batting at .186 this season?
Game yesterday, another one right there. They've clearly got a great plan for how to deal with this guy right now.
Yes.
Now it's going to be Ryan De La Cruz. Yeehaw. Next offering finds the zone of the count as full.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Swings, throw it, and that's a strikeout. Here at Wrigley Field, we head to the bottom of the second. So up now for Chicago, Patrick Wisdom. Swings and blasts one deep to left center.
It's gone.
And that one's gone into the bleachers. A solo shot is 11th of the year, and they add a run. It's 2-0.
some other pitches in this. The bat was very patient, and it paid off.
Now it's Eric Hosmer. Sat out last night's game, but back in there today. Next pitch outside. Is outside.
Bro, you just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
And a swing and a miss.
Oh.
Time to look at our umpiring crew in this one.
Oh, that was harsh.
Yeah, and expect a little.
Good, and I missed.
Okay. Doesn't make any wild calls, but he does give and take there a little bit, so he doesn't have the easiest strike zone to figure out, especially as the game goes on, when you're expecting it to become more consistent.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I could see already is bat.
Oh yeah, we took a
extended period of time. And guys like
Cheo, because he was tired, so that's why Morel's in.
Because of that bat being on plane, and even when you don't get it great, it still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that.
I like Morel.
Here's Yan Gomes. That's off the mark. Two balls, two strikes. Hosmer, the lead runner out at second. Morel out at first with nobody out. Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. Yan Gomes waits, pulls the string with the changeup, struck him out. Back to the top of the lineup. Here's a speed threat, Nico Horner. Hard on the ground to first. The feed for one. What a double play.
Wow. That's crazy.
As the solo shot stretches their lead even further. It's now a 2-0 ball game. You're dialed into the show.
That's just crazy.
Back here at Wrigley Field, here's the center fielder, Jesus Sanchez. Bounce to third. Fair ball. Abisail Garcia up to the plate. Swing and a miss.
One ball.
Gonna count one and two. Nobody out. Runner at first. Now this is in the air down the line. Brings it in with a nice running grab.
Yeah, doubles him off.
Plays are 6-4 threes or something like that. Right there, it's just sort of a combination of good defense.
Boom, gone.
For his first big league hit right here. Got it by him for the K. So up now for Chicago, Dansby Swanson.
Oh, that was too good.
Today with a solo homer in his first at bat. In the air, fairly deep to right field. And Swanson is set down. And there's one down. Up next for Chicago, Ian Happ. He's already singled in this game. One down, base is empty.
You down? Yeah, baby.
Another multi-hit game for him. He's been really hot lately. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
That's a hit. They fired it quickly, so it's first and second with only one away. And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. He hit into a double play his first time up. Line and a base hit.
Oop, not getting chance it. I can chance it.
The runner at third, but the bases are loaded now with one out.
Bringing them together, that's three hits in a row. Nice line drive to the pull side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive.
Oh, now this ball's going to get through, and that's a base hit. One runs in, a second scores as well, and it's 4-0. Safe, he beats it.
Man, he just absolutely
didn't need a home run. That was just all just good little plays. Boink.
and one. Up the middle, birdie. On the run, throw to first. There for the out.
Got an RBI, though.
I love how guys at this level are able to slow the game down, whether it's in the batter's box or on defense. And right there,
bringing in a new pitcher. Oh, man. This man still... Oh, Johnny Cueto. This guy's...
relievers in their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game. Next pitch is popped up.
Oh.
Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Welcome back. John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, John Birdie. Swing and a miss.
One, two.
And a count, one and two.
That was like, that could have gone either way. It literally could have.
Connected from head to toes in terms of the sink of his body. That's his fifth strikeout of the series, and we're just two games in. So, hoping to see some kind of adjustment out of him. His at bats are just a little tough to watch right now.
Varner over to first. Two quick outs here in the top of the fourth. Here's a 1-1. Out towards right center field. Suzuki on the move. And that ends the inning. Nothing doing for the bottom of the fourth. Now the Cubs catcher, Yan Gomes.
It's so hard to read.
You know, these Cubs putting together some really good at bats in this game. There's been a lot to like with how they're approaching their chances at the plate. They were obviously able to run the starter out of the game in the third, so they've set the table for a win, and now I'm sure they're thinking it's time to feast.
Into the outfield, base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you gotta make them pay.
Here's Nico Horner. Grounder might be two. There's one. Over to first, but he beats it.
Really.
And at first, Dansby Swanson digs in now. He's already homered in this game. And a 3-1 on the way. And ball four to aboard.
Big walk.
Walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Next to hit, Ian Happ.
Showed a really nice opposite field approach in his last at bat.
1-1 now. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Puts the squeeze on it, and there are two outs. So first and second with two outs. Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Seiya Suzuki.
Come on, baby.
Bad opposite field knock.
Off the mark there. But now 3-1. First and second, two down. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Boo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I only get one.
The pitcher a false scouting report on me? Yes, I think I could draw a walk. Garcia.
Dang it.
Under this one.
Either way, it was gonna be a strike, or I had to swing at it. So.
Ready now for the fifth inning. Jorge Soler up at the plate. And here's a 3-2. Foul ball, he stays alive. Righty to the plate. Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. 3-2.
Can we get a walk, or?
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another.
You have.
3 balls, 2 strikes, the count.
I'm okay with the hit.
So, man aboard, Brian De La Cruz, the next up for the Marlins. That one in for a strike, 2-2. Righty delivers. Center field. Bellinger drifts towards it.
Puts it away for the out. Throw over to first.
Never know. Never know.
And now it's Garrett Cooper up to him. Struck out swinging his first time. That's inside. Two balls and a strike. And that one fouled off. Soler, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball.
Well, plays made there.
All right, we're going to go start warming up our pitchers.
Back here at the ball.
Bold. Tayon. And... I'm gonna go. There we go. That's who I'm gonna want.
Part. And now here is Patrick Wisdom. The 1-1. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Now the throw to first on the run. Now the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. Here's Hosmer. 1-2. And a pitch. Towards the corner, and that one hops the wall, makes the turn and heads for second. Now the tag at second, and he's out.
Oh, what?
Designated hitter number 5, Christopher Morel.
Christopher Morel.
Wow. So I had something out of the zone again.
And welcome back, top 6. And at the plate for Miami, Kyle Garcia.
You know, these Marlins just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. They've been chasing pitches outside the zone all game, and it's led to some frustrating moments. They've been fooled quite a bit today.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Slider got him for strike 3. The wind of the pitch. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Come on.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. Got a pitch to hit.
Not like I'm giving them, like, really hard pitches, either.
That it was supposed to.
On the ground. Swanson fires over to first. And that is the third out of the inning. Here at Wrigley Field. And now the catcher comes up to him. Yan Gomes. Swing and that ball smashed on a line. And that should be extra bases. And he's got a double. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down. It's like he's moving in full speed and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
And that gets
that's like corner just hitting right there.
Second, it's 6-0, and that's a double.
Just so sound in his mechanics. He hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through. The middle of the field.
At the plate, Dansby Swanson. Swing and a slow roller. On the run, sent it over to first.
We have a runner in scoring position, though, so that's nice.
Earlier enough, got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Ian Happ, the next cup to hit. Good contact guy, good defender. Swing and a miss.
Oh.
Out to short. Slings to first. Now two away as they get a run across.
You would think they'd throw it home sometimes, right? I guess you could always just go back.
Swing and a miss.
Ooh, wee. 1-1 is fouled off. Oh, I like that sinker. I was just very late on it.
And a pitch. Popped up. Cooper makes the catch. That is the end. Back here at Wrigley Field, down to third baseman, Gene Segura.
We'll let him go one more inning.
Stays alive. Ripped on the ground a second. Over to
Hunter. Oh yeah, baby.
That's the first out at the top of the seventh. Luis Arraez stands in. Ball to strike. The pitch. Line drive. And that's a base hit. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
And a 3-2. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Pat moving under it. Hauls it in for the out. The throw in.
You know, we're going to try.
On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. Here's the left fielder. And he got him. Strike three, and that'll retire the side. Bellinger up to hit. 1-for-3. Left-hand batter waits. That one just misses. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Matt Barnes getting loose out there. Scott, a left-hander, also throwing. Ground ball up the middle. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly.
Take that.
And next for the Cubs, Patrick Wisdom. He's already homered here in this one. And a 1-1. Hit weakly on the ground.
Oh, no.
One at second. Throw to first. Safe. And oh, no, it's out of play.
Oh,
saying that's definitely what happened on this play, but it's not a great look.
Arraez gets it to first. Now to
who's up next? It is going to be Morel.
The DH for the Cubs, Christopher Morel. The 2-1. That smash towards center.
That was a good little hit. Just early though.
One left for the Cubs.
Alright. We are going to be putting in Caleb.
Go to the
I like this dude. I just bought his rookie card.
Addy. Center fielder, Jesus Sanchez. And that one fouled off.
When a leadoff man gets on, you want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
And down on strikes. One gone here. Man at first. Next to hit, Abisail Garcia. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Gomes snags it for the second out. Paul McIntosh, the next up for the Marlins. Who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. The other way, that's a hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Just don't give up a run, please.
The Miami order. And now John Birdie. And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Oh yeah! Left two strand, baby.
Whew. Back here at the friendly confines, and here is Yan Gomes.
hit. And the leadoff man aboard. So digging in, Nico Hoerner. Here's a 1-1. They say it went.
You know, these
what? He went?
Getting the bat on the ball this game, and the numbers back that up. Double-digit hits, and they've done a great job of avoiding the strikeout. Only one of them so far, which tells you a lot.
Arrives to second, but safe at first. It's a fielder's choice. Dansby Swanson, the next Cub to hit. Kicks and fires. Maybe a two ball. Five, four, three, double.
It probably started Johnny Soto instead of their starting pitcher.
Welcome back. We go to the ninth, and now it's going to be Gene Segura. On the ground, out to short. Throw to first. Great stretch, and they got him. And up next for Miami, Luis Arraez. Left-hand hitter waits. And a count, 1-2. Got him swinging. On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Jorge Soler. Swing and a miss, 3-2 now.
I'll take a ground ball. That a boy. I was really, really impressed with this team today. Just, we, you know, I wasn't expecting to score that many runs, but I brought in a young pitcher, which I was really happy with. If you could hit that like and subscribe button. Until next time, I'll be having a wonderful day, and bye-bye.